Are you wondering why these? Well, why not? 110cc scooters such as the Honda Activa have been around forever. Even in the maxi scooter department, the choices are quite limited with the Bergman and the SXR. But now, Yamaha has entered the game and it's time we move on to better and more dynamic scooters that are as good as some entry-level motorcycles.
You're watching the AutoX YouTube channel. You can also get your daily dose of all things automotive on our website, autox.com, and follow us on social media. Don't forget to check out our monthly magazine and make sure to hit the bell and subscribe button so you don't miss a thing.
Hello and welcome to AutoX. Coming straight to the point, let me tell you, these scooters are not cheap. At an ex-showroom price of 1.27 lakhs, the Aprilia is priced similar to an entry-level motorcycle. But these scooters demand more because they give more. And that too without the annoying clutch mechanism while returning almost similar fuel efficiency like a motorcycle. Now coming to the Aerox, it's priced at Rs 1.29 lakhs. But for a premium of a couple thousand bucks, you get more storage, more features and more power. But no, it's not the clear winner yet. Well, not until we test them out. The new Yamaha Aerox 155 is the most powerful mass market scooter currently on sale in the Indian market. And that's because it holds the Yamaha R15's unit in its heart. This all-new maxi scooter is powered by a BS6 compliant 155cc single cylinder fuel injected engine and it gets Yamaha's variable valve actuation technology too. This motor churns out 14.7 bhp at 8000 rpm and 13.9 Nm of torque at 6500 rpm. The Aprilia SXR 160 on the other hand also gets a BS6 compliant 160cc single cylinder but air-cooled fuel injected engine. This motor develops 10.7 bhp at 7100 rpm and 11 Nm of torque at 6000 rpm. Both the scooters compared with the CVT. The mechanical difference on paper also reflects on road because nothing can match the Aerox for its speed and agility. The engine is similar to the R15 as I've mentioned earlier and it shows. The throttle response of the Aerox is very crisp. A slight action of your right wrist and it just throws you ahead. High speed stability is fantastic. It hugs corners brilliantly and behaves like a motorcycle on corners. Even when you cross a speed of 80 to 90, it does not feel light or feather-like. You feel pretty confident and stable at all times. Now once you've ridden the Aerox, the SXR feels brisk but just not fast enough. But if you keep the speed factor aside, the power delivery is quite admirable. A speed of 50 to 70 km per hour is its sweet spot because the moment you go over 80, the SXR despite its heavy weight and bulky body starts rattling and losing its ground. But what the Aerox gains in power, it loses in practicality. For example, this underbone chassis. The positioning of the fuel tank as well reduces foot space. I mean, it's all right for me, but a taller person would feel that the knee space is inadequate. Now, on the other hand, for the SXR, despite being a bulky scooter, it simply wins here. So a flat floor bed means you have more space for your luggage and your grocery runs. But again, I would like to mention that the fuel tank, since it's positioned at the front on the Aerox, means it's more practical at the fuel pump. But for the Aprilia, you have to get off the seat as the fuel tank is under it. Although there is space up front, the Aprilia has lesser under-seat storage at 21 litres, whereas the Aerox has 25 litres of storage space. The ride and handling on both scooters, it's quite similar because the mechanism is largely the same. It's just that the Aerox runs on bigger 14-inch wheels and gets double shock absorbers at the rear. So the ride quality is a little more plush when compared to SXR and every other scooter on the market right now. I can assure you that you might start with the Aerox for your grocery runs, but it will not be limited to just that. It's that fun. The Aprilia has a decent ride. It's 50 to 70 kilometers when it performs really well because at high speeds, it gets a little jittery. The ride on the Aprilia SXR, it's quite stiff because of the tiny 12-inch wheels that do nothing to help its cause. The handling is quite good, but not as good as the Aerox. But if I mention that, I have to appreciate it for its seat. It's quite big for the rider and the pillion, whereas pillion seat on the Aerox is quite tiny. The Aerox does not even have grab rails for the pillion rider, whereas the SXR does. The braking on the Aerox feels very progressive, strong and in control all the time. Whereas for the SXR, it feels a bit wooden. The rear feels skittish at times and it's not very confident. Although design is something always open to individual interpretation and choice, I personally think that the Japanese win here today. And I know for a fact that Chuang prefers the SXR over the Aerox in terms of design. Yes, the SXR 160 looks clean, sophisticated without being too much in your face, but the Aerox looks so edgy, something like a baby R15 on smaller wheels. The design is super cool and looks striking on the road, especially the grey vermilion combination. And it deserves more points for being so brave. Plastic quality on both scooters is almost the same, but the finishing is a little better on the Aerox. However, the matte paint job feels more premium on the SXR. The Yamaha is longer than the Aprilia, however, in terms of width, height, wheelbase and ground clearance, the SXR is ahead. The Aprilia is also heavier than the Aerox and it also gets a larger fuel tank capacity. Both of them get an all-digital instrument cluster that shows a ton of information and they feature Bluetooth connectivity too. But neither of them offer navigation, which is quite a bummer. There are two features that I really like on the Aerox: the automatic start-stop feature and the side-stand engine cutoff switch. So what it translates to is that you cannot start your scooter if you have your stand on. So what would make you buy the Aerox 155? Well, it has more power and features like we've discussed, but it's just not a practical scooter, is it? You cannot expect your mother or sister to ride this bike on their grocery runs. That's where the SXR comes in. It's a two-wheeler for everyone in the family. The Aerox is more of a boy racer, for that little brat who wants to go to college but does not want to commit to a motorcycle yet. Even though it's not very practical, this is what I would put my money on. And that is because for this price, it gives more features and more technology. And it's a fun ride. The Aprilia has its X factor, it's an Italian scooter and it looks kick-ass, but the Aerox is after all Yamaha. In the long run, parts will be cheaper and there are more dealerships as compared to Aprilia. Although overall it's a better product, but even if you want that peace of mind, Yamaha might be better than Aprilia.